Tony Khan discusses tonight's huge Mark Briscoe AEW debut, and could WWE be set to sign this current AEW star? But first, Britt Baker has been removed from tonight's episode of AEW Dynamite due to injury, with her three-way match with Tony Storm and Ruby Soho now being changed to a singles match. The news follows last week's angle where Tony Storm and Saraya would turn heel on Dynamite. AEW would break the news on Twitter today and said, "Due to injury, Dr. Britt Baker DMD will not be able to compete in the scheduled three-way match on AEW Dynamite." Following their post-match encounter last Wednesday on Dynamite, it will now be Ruby Soho fighting Tony Storm one-on-one live on TBS at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Central tonight. It's still not 100% clear if the injury is a work or shoot, and whilst she did wrestle on AEW Dark this week against Billy Starks, this was taped back in December. AEW Dynamite is live from Lexington, Kentucky tonight, and we have some news on several unadvertised names that are backstage at the show. According to Fightful Select, Billy Starks is scheduled to appear on tonight's AEW Dark taping. Jake the Snake Roberts is also said to be at the show, as is Best Friends and Brody King, despite not being advertised. RJ City is also in attendance, with him set to record for his AEW YouTube show, and interestingly, Dax Harwood and Cash Wheeler are also in town, this despite being on a break from wrestling, and this is said to have been the case even before the Jay Briscoe tribute match between Jay Lethal and Mark Briscoe was announced. Whether any of these names appear on screen is yet to be confirmed. Back in November 2020, All Elite Wrestling would announce that they're working on their first ever video game in collaboration with Ukes, the creators of the legendary SmackDown series. More than 2 years later, and despite plans for its release in September 2022, the game is still not on shelves, with the reason for this seemingly now being revealed. According to WrestleZone, there has been issues with the game's age rating, with AEW unable to attain the teen rating that they desire, and WrestleZone would report, "A source close to the situation has confirmed that there have been some issues regarding the rating for AEW Fight Forever, which has delayed an announcement of a release date for the game. Other sources have told me in recent weeks the amount of blood and gore in AEW Fight Forever prevented the game from achieving a teen rating on multiple occasions." On the bright side, those close to the game are confident with where things are now, as the game has once again been resubmitted to the ESRB recently after multiple back and forths on it. As for what the specific issues were with the ESRB, the source didn't detail what needed to be addressed. Despite that, they did say that everyone is feeling pretty confident that the issues are resolved, but they won't know for sure until it officially comes back. According to Pro Wrestling Torch, Impact Wrestling have officially signed former WWE superstar Connor, who was a member of the Ascension tag team. The former NXT tag champion, now going by the name of Con, made his Impact debut in February 2022, before later returning as a member of the Violent by Design faction in November, and has now officially signed a multi-year deal with the company, according to the report. This past Monday on Raw Triple X, a steel cage match between Becky Lynch and Bayley did not go ahead as planned, with Io Sky and Dakota Kai instead attacking Lynch before the match could get underway. Reports then emerged that it was cut short due to the trial of Sami Zayn's segment going too long, meaning the match had to be turned into an angle. PW Insider are now reporting that the original plan would have seen Becky Lynch walk away as the winner before then beating down Damage Control, much like we saw on the night. In a recent interview with Tokyo Sport, IWGP World Heavyweight Champion Kazuchika Okada would have discussed his idea for a cross-promotion wrestling world cup, with him open to reaching out to WWE's Triple H or AEW's Tony Khan to make this a reality. Speaking on the Battleground podcast this week, Tony Khan himself would reveal that he's open to the idea and said, "I've got experience working with different promotions and promoting angles, matches, and storylines across different companies. It can be challenging, but we came together with New Japan Pro Wrestling to put on, I think, the best pay-per-view of the year last year, Forbidden Door. There are challenges to putting on an event like that and getting the matches set, but it's certainly something I would be open to. I'm open to working with anybody in pro wrestling. You never know." Since their relationship became public in January 2022, Sammy Guevara and Ty Mello have often been seen together on screen, much to the disdain of the AEW fanbase. During a recent virtual signing on the Captain's Corner Facebook page, Penelope Ford would say that she feels Sammy and Ty's act is a carbon copy of hers and Kip Sabian's, before Kip would then answer if they want the smoke, and he would say, Let's get down to brass tacks here. Let's be brutally honest. They're basically doing the characters that we did prior to my injury. Let's be serious. So of course there's room for it, but it depends whether they want the heat, whether they want the smoke. I mean, technically Sammy's never beaten me, but I beat him. First ever AEW match. No one's taking that from me. I'm gonna die on that hill. TNA founder Jeff Jarrett would take to his My World podcast this week, where he addressed rumors that at one stage, Bill Goldberg was close to joining the now Impact Wrestling. Jarrett would reveal that talks did take place at one stage, however the company simply couldn't afford what it would have cost them to bring in the WCW legend, and he would say, Dixie Carter had a lunch with him several years later that I think you could classify on Dixie's part for sure, substantially. I don't think on Bill's part. Bill made a lot of money in WCW and made a lot of money at WWE. Bill's a businessman first and foremost. I never viewed any of the conversations with Bill as substantial, strictly off of there isn't enough money for Bill to come in. And next, Tony Khan discusses tonight's huge Mark Briscoe AEW debut. Last night, AEW would announce that Mark Briscoe would be making his debut on tonight's episode of Dynamite to honor his late brother Jay in a match with Jay Lethal. Originally, it was said that Mark was still banned from appearing on AEW television by Warner Bros. Discovery due to comments made on social media by Jay Briscoe a decade ago, the same reason they didn't appear on the show in 2022, and the same reason a proper on-air tribute wasn't allowed last Wednesday. Speaking on the Battleground podcast last night, AEW and ROH owner Tony Khan would reveal how hard he fought to push for Mark to honor his brother and said, it's going to be a great match to honor a great man. These two men requested this match. Wednesday would be the 39th birthday of the late great Jay Briscoe. His longtime friend and rival Jay Lethal and his brother Mark Briscoe wanted to have this match to honor the legacy of Jay Briscoe, and I fought hard to make it happen, and I'm really excited about the match. I believe it's going to be a great one, and it's great that they're going to be able to honor the legacy of somebody that everybody in pro wrestling has so much respect for, the great Jay Briscoe, on his 39th birthday. With everything happening, this is going to be something really great for everybody in the locker room who is rallying around the Briscoe family. Discussing last week's passing of Jay Briscoe, Khan would reveal the internal reaction within AEW's locker room and said, the whole thing was a shock to everybody, and I think everybody in the locker room immediately trying to rally around Jay's family, around Mark, and everybody trying to bring good energy together to try and support Jay's two daughters in their recovery from what was a tragic accident. Thankfully, there has been some positive news about the recovery that Jay's two daughters are making from the accident. The whole thing has been a shock. It's at least beautiful that everybody can come together on Wednesday Night Dynamite and honor the life and legacy of Jay Briscoe this week, because it's not only a week since he was tragically taken away, but it's also his 39th birthday. It's a beautiful thing that his brother Mark and his longtime friend and rival Jay Lethal can go out there and go one-on-one to celebrate Jay Briscoe on AEW Dynamite. It's certainly going to be emotional when Mark pays homage to the late great Jay Briscoe, and whilst it is a shame that it took this situation to make a Briscoe AEW appearance happen, at least Jay will finally get the tribute he should have gotten last week on TBS. And next, could WWE be set to sign this current AEW star? In a recent upcoming free agents video, we discussed the expiring AEW contract of Brian Cage, a situation we now have more information on. According to a fresh report from Fightful Select, Cage's deal with the company is set to expire in a matter of weeks. This despite him being one third of the reigning ROH six-man tag champions alongside Embassy teammates Korn and Toa Leona. The report notes that there have been feelers within WWE that have gauged the company interest in bringing Cage in, although it's not entirely clear if there was interest from either side. With that said, Cage does have the WWE look about him, and his experience and age could see him become a valuable asset were he to make the jump. The Brian Cage situation is certainly one to watch in the coming weeks, and the immediate booking of the ROH six-man titles will be a big tell as to what his future could hold. And before you go, make sure you check out 10 upcoming wrestling free agents that you need to know.